हेलो और नमस्ते. विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद द एफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन दैट इज इन प्रोबेबिलिटी थ्योरी एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स. द एफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑल्सो नोन एज स्नेडिकर्स एफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन और फिशर स्नेडिकर एफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विच एज नेम्ड आफ्टर रोनाल्ड फिशर एंड जॉर्ज स्नेडिकर इज अ कंटिन्यूअस प्रोबेबिलिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन दैट अराइजेज फ्रिक्वेंटली एज द नल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ अ टेस्ट स्टैटिस्टिक. Most notably in the analysis of variance, which is also known as ANOVA. So in this particular session, we'll be going ahead and just exploring the what is the F distribution, the important properties of F distribution, as well as the F test for the significance of the difference between the population variances, as well as we'll be exploring the F table. Snedeker's F distribution has been a random variable, capital F is said to follow Snedeker's F distribution or simply F distribution if its probability density function is given by F of capital F, which is equals to nu 1 upon nu 2, the whole power nu 1 by 2, divided by beta of nu 1 by 2, comma nu 2 by 2. This nu 1 we have already introduced in the sampling, wherein the degrees of freedom, the definition of degrees of freedom. So this is nu 1 and nu 2, they are the Greek letters, and it's known as the, actually it's a lowercase Greek letter which is known as the degrees of freedom, or you can say that the notation for the degrees of freedom. F to the power nu 1 by 2 minus 1, or nu 1 by 2 minus 1, divided by 1 plus nu 1 f upon nu 2, whole to the power nu 1 plus nu 2 by 2, wherein this f is greater than 0. Notes: the sampling distribution of f follows statistics does not involve any population parameters and depends only on the degrees of freedom nu 1 and nu 2. The statistic f following the Snedeker's f distribution with nu 1, nu 2 degrees of freedom will be denoted by f follows f distribution with nu 1, nu 2 as the parameters. So in this f distribution will be having nu 1 and nu 2 as the parameter of the distribution. Properties of f distribution. The probability curve of f distribution is roughly sketched in the figure. So if you'll observe here, this is the figure which is known as the f distribution figure, and this is the acceptance region, wherein this is the rejection of the region of rejection. F of nu 1 dot nu 2 of alpha, so that means what, this is the point wherein we have to have this point, this alpha, and this is this particular region has been getting divided into two. One is the region of rejection, one is the region of acceptance, or region of acceptance here. A square of the t variate with n degrees of freedom follows a f distribution with 1 and n degrees of freedom. The mean of the f distribution is nu 2 upon nu 2 minus 2, where nu 2 is greater than 2. The variance of the f distribution is this given by this particular equation. I have just purposely put this particular slide so that you will have the notes for the f distribution. Similarly, what are the applications of f distribution? The f distribution is used to test the equality of variance of the population from which two small samples have been drawn. F test. Now this is one of the F distribution gives us the F test. F test is the sig of the significance of difference between the population of variance and F table. So we'll be discussing about this two. One is the application, which is the difference between the population variance and F table. To test the significance of difference between the population variance, we shall first find their estimates mu 1 square and mu 2 square based on the sample variance S1 square and S2 square, and then the test their equality. Now this different books are using the different notation. Some of them are using this as SX square, SY square, and so on. So we will be sticking to this particular notation, which is I have taken it from the standard book of the statistics. Now mu 1 square is equal, so now it's you will be observing here mu 1 cap squared, which is equals to n1 s1 square upon n1 minus 1, whereas degrees of freedom is nu 1, which is given as n1 minus 1. What is this n1 means? We will just define it everything ahead. Mu 2 square or mu 2 cap square is equals to n2 s2 square upon n2 minus 1, whereas degrees of freedom is equals to nu 2 equals to n2 minus 1. And this F, this is known as the F statistics, which is equals to mu 1 cap square upon mu 2 cap square, which follows the frequency distribution or the F distribution nu 1 comma nu 2. So this is follow this particular F distribution or F statistics follows the distribution F with the parameters mu 1 and mu 2. Now, if from this equality, you can observe here, if mu 1 cap square is equals to mu 2 cap square is equals to F equals to 1. That means what? If these two are equal, obviously this division, or you can say this the quotient will give us this this quotient will give us equals to 1. So the value of F becomes here 1. And that's the reason we always try to find out how far any observed value of F can differ with or the from the unity as a result of fluctuations of sampling. That's the reason we are always trying to get this mu 1 always greater than mu 2, right? And that's the reason here it is always have to be greater than 1 or equals to. We will be just observing the difference between the unity from the unity. Now Snedeker has prepared tables that give for different values of mu 1 and mu 2 the 5% and 1% critical values of F. The F denotes the observed or calculated value, and F of mu 1, mu 2 of alpha denotes the critical or tabulated value of F at LOS, that is level of significance alpha. So we are considering here alpha level of significance. In the F distribution, we'll be having it 5% or 1%. Then probability of F greater than F of mu 1, mu 2 at alpha. That means here is equals to alpha. That means in the similar kind, what we are having the Z table or standard normal table, similarly we do have it, the table for the F test as well, or you can say the Snedeker's F distribution as well, for 5% and for 1% critical values, or you can say the level of significance, that is alpha. And similarly for the T distribution, what we have the degrees of freedom, similarly we do have the degrees of freedom. Now in the T distribution, we do have the degrees of freedom only one, wherein because we are finding out here the distribution or the difference between the two samples, we'll be having it nu 1 and nu 2 are the degrees of freedom. And if you'll observe here, a few notes will be just observe here. That is, F test is not a two-tail test and is always right tail. It's not two-tail and it's a right tail test, since F cannot be negative. F cannot be negative. Just very important step to note this down. That is, F cannot be negative. Thus, if F greater than F of nu 1, nu 2, alpha, then the difference between F and 1, that is the difference between sigma 1 square and sigma 2 square, is significant at level of significance of alpha or alpha level of significance. In other words, the samples may not be regarded as drawn from the same population or from the population with the same variance. And if it is F is less than F of nu 1, nu 2, alpha, at alpha you can say the difference is not significant at level of alpha level of significance. And we'll always try to make F greater than 1, and by taking the larger of two estimates, mu 2 square as mu 1 square, right? So if this particular mu 2 is greater, then we will consider that as mu 2 and we will keep that in the numerator, right? In the numerator, and by assuming that the corresponding degrees of freedom as mu 1. Similarly, two tests of two small samples have been drawn from the same normal population. It is not enough to test if their means differ significantly or not, because in this test we assume that the two samples came from the same population or from population with equal variance. So before applying the T test for the significance of difference of two sample means, we should always satisfy ourselves about the equality of the population variances by F test. So this is one of the very important property which connects, which getting connected between the T distribution and the F distribution. Yeah, this is the F table. I've just purposely taken it. Let me just give you this here. Let me just choose the highlighter. If you observe here, this alpha is equals to 0.05. So for this particular table, F table, I have taken just the help of this alpha equals to 0.05, because if the alpha is not given or not asked or not considered or given in the example, we always go for alpha is equals to 5%. That is alpha equals to 0.05. And if you observe this rows over here, this rows are nothing but DF1. That is, this is for the value for new one. These are the values. So the row values are for the new one and the column values are for new two. So this is the way. So DF1 is for the rows here and DF2 is for the particular columns here. So this DF1 is for the rows. Similarly, this DF2 is for the columns. Okay, just give me back. Yeah. So this, suppose, for example, I just need to select the pen. Yeah. Yes. Okay, so suppose we wanted to have a new one as equals to say for 6 and new 2 is equals to say for 7, then I have to take it new one as 6, though 6 from here, that is 6th column, wherein new 2 is 7, that means here, and the intersection of them will give us the value of this F value. So this is nothing but the value F at, or you can say F tabulated value at new 1 at 6 and new 2 at equals to 7. So we will just discuss about the different questions. I have taken the screenshot for particular thing that also to just make you understand everything. Okay, let us go for the first example here. A sample of size 13 gave an estimated population variance of 3, while another sample size 15 gave an estimate of 2.5. Could both samples be from population with the same variance? So this is the type of question we'll be getting it whenever we have to deal with the F distribution, or you can say the Snedeker's F distribution. Now we have been given two samples. One is this having this properties, that is N1 is 13, mu1 square is equals to 3, and new one as 12. Why it's 12? Because this new one is nothing but N1 minus 1, which is equals to 13 minus 1, that is equals to 12. Similarly, this 14 is nothing but 15 minus 1. This, in this way, we have got new 1 and new 2. And this variances has been given here in this particular thing. Now, two samples have been drawn from the population with the same variance means what? Oh, just a minute. Let me just erase that. Yeah. That means this is the H0. You can say the null hypothesis becomes your mu1 square is equals to mu2 square. So now, right now I'm not talking this as a cap, but you can just go ahead with the cap also. Then H1 is mu1 square is not equals to mu2 square. So H1 and H0, they are always inverses, or you can say the opposites of each other. If this is the equality sign, the H1 will give me not equal. Then this, again, in this particular question, the LOS is not given, so we'll be considering 5%. This is what F? mu1 square upon mu2 square. And that's the reason we have taken, because as I have told you, mu1 square would always be greater than the other one. So the number which is greater will be always considered that as mu1, sigma1 square, right? That is what, that would be sigma1 square, and we'll be writing this in the denominator, in the numerator. Divided by 2.5, which is equals to 1.2. And now, if you observe here, new 1 is 12, new 2 is 14. New 1 is 12. So I need to check this out. And new 2 is 14. 14 over here. So if you observe the intersection of these two, will give us the value as 2.5342. And that, therefore, the value, that is F of 0.05%, that is that alpha label, new 1 is 12, new 2 is 14, is equals to 2.53. We have taken just up to two digits over here. That means F is less than this, and this implies H0 we are accepting, because it's coming under the acceptance region. Because this point is coming under the acceptance region, right? If you'll observe that particular curve over here, this is what a curve, something like this, we have taken it. And this is the point, this is the point here, that is the point 2.53 here. And this 2.53, this 1.2 is coming under somewhere here, and that is which is in the acceptance region, and that's the reason we are accepting this H0. That means two samples could have. So we cannot just say that yes, it is completely or compulsory it has come. We have to say that yes, could have come from the two normal populations with the same PIDAS. Similarly, the same question, similar question, I have taken it here. If you'll observe here, size 9, size 8, and the means equals to 160 and 91. There is a difference because in the previous question, they have directly given us the variances, and wherein in this case, they have given us the mean. So that means if you'll observe here, squares of deviations from their respective means is 160. That means it's been given to us summation of xi minus x bar square. X bar the whole square is been given to us as 160. Similarly, summation of yi minus y bar the whole square is given to us as 91. And this is what? Now, this summation of xi minus x bar the whole square is nothing but n1 s1 squared. S1 is what? S1 is the sample variance. S1 square is the sample variance, and s1 is the standard deviation of that. This has been given to us 160, and that also formula we have written, that is sigma 1 square is n1 s1 square upon n1 minus 1. That is what I think we have done it in the first or second slide, which is equals to this 20. Similarly, sigma 2 square is also, we have got it as 13. And then as sigma 1 square is greater than sigma 2 square, we have chosen this as sigma 1 square and this is sigma 2 square. So 20 by 13 we'll be getting. And these are the new one and new two. New one is 8, new two is 7. And we have got it, this H0, H1, and we'll be getting at 5% LOS. This is the value of F statistic, that is 1.54 20 by 13. And if you'll observe here, we have got new one as 8. So this is 8 over here. And then 7 is here. So the intersection point, that is, this is 3.7257 would be the F tabulated value, that is 3.73 value, and which if you observe here again, it's less than the value of this critical value or the critical value. That's the reason we can conclude H0 is accepted. If it is accepted, the two samples could have come from the normal population with the same variance. So it's almost similar. Only the difference, every question I have taken in the first question, the variance is directly given. In the second question, the sum of squares of their deviations has been given. The next question is, again, it's a different, which is the directly the values are given, the X and Y values are given. And again, the similar kind of question, the sample size has been displayed over here. So for the first sample, summation of X, so this, you can just refer the session from this the channel wherein I have explained how to find out if the values of the samples are given, how to find out the value of the sigma square, that is the standard deviation of a sample. You can directly find it out. Otherwise, this is the formula which I have displayed it here. We have to take the summation of x square, and then this is what is the s1 square, and we will be getting s1 square as 4.19. Similarly, for the second sample, we can go ahead. Otherwise, you can directly get this particular value from the calculator. Just follow the session. Mathematical Tools is the playlist which I have explained here, the 991 ES and EX calculator, where you can just go ahead and get this, feed this particular values in the array of this X. Okay, then what will happen? The sigma 1 square, we can calculate S1 square upon N1 minus 1, which is 4.72. Similarly, sigma 2 square, again, it's greater than sigma 2. Sigma 1 square is greater than sigma 2 square, and new 1 is 7, new 2 is 6, and these are the H0 and H1 will be 96. We have got 1.21, and we have got this particular. Now, new 1 is 7, new 2 is 6. The intersection of them would give us this value, 4.2061, that is 4.21 for the up to two digits, and that's the reason, again, it's less than the critical value. H0 is accepted. That means mu 1 square and mu 2 square do not differ significantly at 5% level of significance. This is all about the F distribution and different type of question. How the question is getting different by giving by the different values of being given in the question. I hope you have understood the F distribution. Thank you. Happy learning.